Hey everyone, this is Queen Sugar. So tonight, I'm going to try something new. I'm going to try the new spread for a reading that I'm going to do monthly. So the goal for this reading is to kind of be like a monthly update for the Divine Counterparts, Twin Flames, Soulmates, Divine Feminine, Divine Masculine. So I'm going to look into the Divine Feminine and the Divine Masculine sides. And just please select whatever side best resonates with you. We all embody feminine and masculine energy, so sometimes one side may be a little bit stronger or more present than the other one, depending on the season. I plan on getting the overall theme of the month and then divide the reading into sections. So like one side would be about the divine feminine, the other side would be about the divine masculine, and then at the end, I'll do like an overall energy. And at the beginning, I also will do like an overall theme energy for the two. And we'll get the current energies, we'll get the future energies and possible outcomes and any advice that may be needed. Okay, so we're gonna get started now. All right, so for these readings, I'm gonna use 4 decks. I won't use tarot in this particular reading or recording. I'm going to try it out and just see how it goes. And if spirit moves me to use tarot in the next readings, I will do so. But tonight I will be using the Romance Angels, the Soul Journey deck, the Energy Oracle deck, and then my personalized Melanin Messages deck. So we're going to start off with the overall theme for the month of July 2019. The divine, masculine, and feminine, twin flame, soulmate, however you want to identify yourself. So let's start off with that. So I've already shuffled the cards beforehand, so I'm just immediately going to get into the theme. So the overall theme from the Romance Oracle deck is wedding. Let's get a soul journey card as well. And I'll go into more detail. So we have the card acceptance. I'm learning to accept the things that I cannot change. So these are the cards that represent the overall theme for the Divine Masculine and the Divine Feminine. And so with this being the theme for July, I'm getting the sense that both parties are thinking about the long-term like life with their divine counterpart, whether you know them or you don't know them. And it seems that a lot of the divine counterparts do want to be with this person. And the wedding card has been coming out a lot in the divine masculine channel messages that I've been doing. So this is actually like perfect because it just shows that the divine masculine hasn't given up on this connection, has given up on the divine feminine. And with the acceptance cards here, this is saying that it is time to accept the things that you cannot change and accept the things that you can change and that you can work on right now. So we're going to start off with the divine feminine side. So we're going to get the current energy, what is to come, so like the future energy, and then any advice. And then also we're going to do the same with the divine masculine. So let's get a soul card for the divine feminine. What is the current energy of the divine feminine? Understand that nothing can grow or evolve without movement. So the divine feminines right now are embodying change. They know that if there's not change within the relationships or within, you know, in life, they have to do something about it. You can't sit in silence or not do anything if you want change, even if it's in regards to relationships. You have to accept the things you cannot change. You have to accept the things you can change. And as you change within and heal within, you are able to have the change within your life. And so the melanin messages that the divine feminine received were blindness and forgiveness and healing. So if the divine feminine, if you want to feel change or see change, you have to forgive and heal. You have to continue healing with it. You have to continue to forgive others that may have hurt you in the past. And you cannot be blind to it anymore. Because if you are blind to it, you miss out on the blessings that are around you. As you can see, there are like coins and there are beautiful butterflies around her, but she's blindfolded. And she doesn't see the beauty that is around her and that's surrounding her because she's blindfolded. And by not forgiving or not healing, that causes that blindness. So this is not the current energy. So the divine feminine is definitely working on seeing things for what they are, but also forgiving and healing. So actually, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna do them in the same like order. So like as I do the divine feminine's current energy, I'll do the divine masculine's current energy. Spirit is moving me to do it that way, so I'll do it that way. So let's get some cards for the divine masculine current energy. So this is the divine masculine's current energy. Stepping into their divine power and seeing things for what they are and what they can create. They're accepting that they are a divine counterpart and that they can manifest whatever it is that they want to manifest, whether it's money or a relationship. Now, if someone is abundant, that doesn't necessarily mean like they are always 100% happy or they don't have any obstacles, but this is just saying that the divine masculine strength energy is that they are starting to see that they deserve abundance and that they can manifest it, but they have to obviously, you know, work on some things in order to truly manifest it. So take some melanin messages about this abundance card for the divine masculine. Beautiful. So this represents, in like the traditional tarot when I created this deck, this will be like the death card. And they are transforming. They are seeing that even though cycles have ended, even though people have left their lives, even though they have cut people out of their lives, there is still life. There is still something there. And it's a fresh beginning. And then we have the balance card. So this would be like the temperance card in the traditional tarot deck. And they are becoming aligned with their higher self. They are balancing themselves out. And they are healing themselves. So as the divine feminine heals herself and continues to forgive, this allows the divine masculine to balance those energies out. So it's definitely a counterpart energy that's going on right now in regards to like as one person does something, the other person receives like the output of it. So now let's get into what is to come. So like, what are the future energies for the month of July? Divine feminine. What are the future energies for the month of July? So we have fear. I realize that I am testing my resolve to live in the energy of love. Okay, let's get some clarifying cards for that. So I'm not getting the vibe that the divine feminine is like, you're going to have something where you have to be fearful this month. I'm getting the vibe that you are no longer sitting in fear. It's like you're going to possibly take this mask off and see things for what they are and go into the light. That's like abundance and prosperity. neutral energies for the feminine spirit. Okay. Mm-hmm. So we have soulmate, and then we have romantic date. So this works well, actually. So this is saying that as you step out of that fear, as you let go of the fear that your divine counterpart will come back, or that you will never find love or something, you will manifest your soulmate, your divine counterpart. You will manifest a romantic date with this person. Now, it doesn't necessarily have to be in July, but they're saying as you step out of that fear, as you take off your mask and forgive and heal, you will manifest this beautiful energy in the month of July and leading towards the month of August. So let's see what's happening with the Divine Masculine for future energies for July. So we have two cards. So we have Blame. I accept the responsibility for my well-being, which kind of matches the acceptance. It really matches the acceptance thing, because the Divine Masculine is understanding that I need to take accountability for my actions that I've done in the past that may have hurt my Divine Feminine and others in my life. And then Empathy. I am open to seeing both sides of the situation. So someone with the Divine Feminine may have been kind of closed out to the Divine Masculine due to the past, and the Divine Masculine understands it now. They see why. They understand it, and they accept that blame. They take that blame, and they're owning their actions. The structure card represents the Emperor. So the Divine Masculine, as they take their blame responsibility, as they transform, as they balance their energies, as they accept things for what they are and balance themselves, they begin to build structure within their life. Therefore, they can build structure and a foundation with their Divine Feminine. So the Divine Masculine in the month of July is definitely working on healing and also growing and balancing themselves so they could be the structural figure in the relationship and the connection, which is beautiful. Because if you look here in this card, the Divine Masculine is like protecting the Divine Feminine. She looks safe within the Divine Masculine's arms. She's resting her head on his chest, and he's like hovering her because he's protecting her. And then when you think of marriage, that should be one of the ways marriages are looked at and received, that the Divine Masculine protects the Divine Feminine, as well as the Divine Feminine protects the masculine, but also just being that foundation, that support is important. Okay, so let's get some advice from the Energy Oracle deck for the month of July for the Divine Feminine. What advice do you have for the Divine Feminine in the month of July spirit? So we have two cards. So we have, we have a man holding your heart in anxiety. And what I'm getting from this is that the Divine Feminine, you need to not be worried about what the Divine Masculine is doing in regards to the connection and how they're going to approach you. Just know that you have the Divine Masculine's heart. They love you, and they are coming towards you. They want this marriage, they want this commitment with you, but you have to continue to forgive and to heal. You have to continue to no longer be afraid. And just, you know what, now that I'm thinking about it, you did get the fear card. So with fear and anxiety, spirit is saying do not be afraid, do not worry about anything that you cannot control or anything that you cannot see. The storm is over, the storm has passed, and it is passing if you're in the storm. So don't fear it. Don't be afraid. Because if you are afraid, you don't allow your Divine Masculine to come in and do the great things that they want to do, because they feel that fear. And when you radiate fear to them, they're going to just kind of push themselves away and just not come in because they feel that fear, which is going to allow them to feel fear. So spirit wants you to not be afraid and just trust. Trust and believe in your divine masculine, regardless of what they have done in the past. Because if you still hold on to that, then you have not forgiven them. You have not healed from that. So you have to forgive and heal and let it go. It doesn't mean you have to necessarily, just give them a fresh, clean slate automatically. But if you want this with your divine masculine, you have to heal and you have to forgive. That's the only way that union can happen. Because you don't want to get into a union with your divine counterpart and you haven't forgiven them. You haven't healed from the past, hurt from them or other people. You want to make sure everyone is pretty much at a level where they are aligned and they can balance each other in some way. Alright, let's get an energy oracle card or cards for the divine masculine. What advice do you have for the divine masculine spirit? It is time to share what you feel with your divine feminine. It is time to open your heart. And in order for the divine masculine to do that, the divine feminine, once again, has to make sure that their heart is opening, that their heart is ready to receive love and give love, which requires to forgive and to heal. So as the divine feminine forgives and heals, the divine masculine is able to forgive and heal as well, and also open their heart and express their love and appreciation of their divine feminine. But the divine feminine cannot sit in fear. They cannot sit in anxiety. They have to be willing to take this mask off and forgive and heal so the divine masculine can come in and express their love and their appreciation. But also, the divine feminine is important for you to heal anyway, regardless of your twin flame or soulmate. You don't want to sit in hurt and pain for the rest of your life. So it is important for you to heal and to grow and to forgive. Alright, and we're in the last part. So let's get an overall energy between both parties for the month of July. So I'm going to use the romance and the soul card for that. So let's get one romance card. Overall energy for the month of July 2019 between the divine masculine and the divine feminine. We have finances and career. Financial issues are affecting your love life right now. So I mentioned this in a channel message that I received from the divine masculine, that they were having some financial problems this month, or they're currently going through it. So with this being the overall energy, this means that both parties will be working on themselves financially and work-wise. And I mentioned this before in like another video, possibly a pick a pile, that finances and love are very related. They are related. Because if you are not open to receiving something, then you don't get a lot of it. Or if you give too much of something, you don't have a lot left for yourself. So there is a balance and need of financial stability and self-love and care for both the divine masculine and the divine feminine. I'm actually going to get one more romance card as well. So yeah, stay optimistic about your love life. Positive thinking and faith will bring you romance. So I feel like that the finances and career is really for the masculine, and the stay optimistic about your love life is for the divine feminine. But both can be applied to both energies. But with the word faith and positive thinking coming out, this is really resonating with the divine feminine, and then the finances relates to the divine masculine per the channel message that I did the other day. So please stay optimistic about your love life and know that if you think positively about it, you're going to see positive changes. But if you continue to stay blind to the beauty that is around you, and not forgive and not heal, then you won't see that change. And I'll get energy. Actually, I'll do like a soul card for the remaining part of this message. So overall energy between the two for the month of July 2019. Beautiful. We have honesty. So I cannot expect the truth from others, but I can expect it from myself. So each party needs to be honest with themselves. What are you struggling with right now? What have you not forgiven the masculine about, divine feminine? What are you still blind to? What are you still struggling with? Why are you still afraid? Be honest with yourself and dig deep. And divine masculine, why are you having challenges with your money right now? Is it because you are not open to receiving love? Is it because you have a block in your heart chakra? What have you not balanced out in your life, divine masculine, that is causing this difficulty with finances, this imbalance in your structure? So think about those things. Be honest with yourself. And you don't have to share those answers or those responses with others. You can keep them to yourself. But Spirit is saying that the month of July requires honesty. It requires vulnerability. It requires you to be to no longer be afraid. Because if you are afraid, then you cannot move forward. And then the last part we're going to do for this reading is mental entrapment. So be honest. Do not let those negative thoughts sit in your mind and cause fear and anxiety. This is for both sides. Because as you acknowledge those fears and acknowledge those hurts, you no longer give it power. Because you acknowledged it and then you're not afraid of it anymore. So it's time to recognize what they are, heal and forgive if needed, balance your energies, balance your chakras, and then stay optimistic and have faith. And watch finances improve, watch your love life improve, watch your self-love and confidence improve. Okay? So this is a monthly update that I'm going to possibly start doing each month. So I kind of started this like in the middle of July, but it's never too late to do a recording about the month of July. So expect to see these monthly. I'll try to do them at the beginning of the month. That way people can have an idea what to expect in the month as it arrives. So I'll probably do the August video towards the end of July, or like the first day or first few days of August. So I hope you all enjoyed this video. Please like, share, and subscribe. Feel free to share your comments below and talk about, you know, what resonates with you, what didn't resonate with you if you want, and provide any suggestions that you may have or would like to see in future videos. Thank you so much for tuning in. I appreciate all the love and support. Have a wonderful, blissful day, evening, night, whatever time period you are in when you watch this video. Peace and love.